Hey everyone, Scott here. I have to be really quiet today because it's almost 1 a.m. and I am at home in my kitchen and Sarah is sleeping. Obviously, I don't want to wake anyone up. So I'm going to try something new today for a video. I'm going to draw for a little bit. Not really drawing, but using chalk, pastel, and on some new medium that I bought today. So just some sketching. I think I want to do a Luna moth. It's like my favorite insect. And I tried drawing it once, but I'm going to try again with a pastel. So, actually, I'll show you guys. I've got this cool new like stand. I think it's called a gooseneck stand. Here, check this out. It's just one of those durable like cable lamps that you use. But it's a stand, it's for your phone. It clamps in. Pretty cool. So far it seems really sturdy. It's just holding a phone. So, yeah, let's do this. So here it is, guys. What's this called? It's just, yeah. Some black paper. It's a mixed media, so I think it's got some texture. It's good for, like, just pastel and stuff. It's only 15 sheets though. Didn't notice that before. It's alright. Let's line that up again. Yeah, so I'm gonna try out drawing a Luna moth. My favorite animal. Full disclosure, I do have an image on my laptop right in front of me of the Luna moth. Just because I'm not very good at drawing things from imagination, you know? Like, I draw for, like, fun, you know? I'm not trying to, like, prove myself or try to make a career out of it, you know? Just for fun. It's a hobby, so I do look at pictures. Maybe I'll overlay some of my old drawings that I've done throughout my life. I'll show some of them to you. I do like doing it, and I am proud of my work that I do, even though if you Google it, you can find it in like 10 seconds on that first page you're looking at, but that's okay. Again, it's for fun. It's not anything but that. So here's some of my pastels I bought recently, or it was a gift. I don't really remember. If it was a gift, I'm sorry, I forgot. Let's try to look at some colors here, see what we could use. Some purple. Some type of pink, right? Try these. Oh no! That's the one thing about this package, it always happens if I'm not paying attention. This like outer case, or inner case I should say. Oops. And it's so annoying to get back in. Everything into place, I mean. Jeez. I might have to edit this one out. Here we go. Sorry about that, guys. That will not be the last time that happens. I do it all the time when I'm using these. But yeah, so here we go. I think usually when I like to draw, like, I do like a light trace, well not trace, but a light sketch first, just so you can get the feeling of like the shape of what I'm drawing, you know? One thing I have been working on for a long time with drawing anything is symmetry. So like onto the right side and like getting the same exact distance or shape on the left. I still have a lot of trouble with that. But you gotta start somewhere, right? So I'll work on it. And sometimes, like, for people who don't usually draw, I like to, this is a common trick, I think, but I like to break down things in shapes. So always this moth is, like, kind of a, like, a trapezoid almost. So you can do things like that, and then just work with it. These Luna moths have this really cool, like, end of their tail. Like, it doesn't just come in, it kind of, like, wisps out like this. Yeah, kind of like that. I am a little worried now that I went too dark on this white. I kind of, like, wasn't paying attention. Whatever, we learn, and we keep going. Got kind of the body right here. One second, I forgot something super important, my eraser. So I'm gonna try to like, I bought a new eraser because I don't usually use chalk pencils that much, so I'm not experienced, but I'm going to try to get rid of some of this excess with my new eraser. Alright, yeah, so when you're using like pastels and stuff, you don't want to use normal erasers, it's not going to work. So you need these kneaded erasers. I just bought this at Michael's. Michael's are any craft store, right? Yeah. Let's see what we can do here. Again, I've never done this, I don't know how well it's gonna come out. Bad guys. Again, I think it went a little bit too dark. I should have been lighter with the white, but I mean, Luna Moth is a really light color anyways. That's why I use white. So it'll probably blend really well later on, you know? Let's see some of these colors. Luna Moth has this like really cool outline on its wing and head. All the way to the tip of the wing. Put some pink in there. Blend that. They got this cool pattern on their top wings like that. The color kind of arches down into it. if we can get some green in here. I don't know. I don't think I have the best choices for green, honestly, in this set. Let's see. That's a really light. That's a good place to start, at least. Let's see what we can get here. See what this color brings. Now usually I would test, like, if I don't know the color, I would always test it, but I'm kind of experimenting here, so I just want to go for it. I do like that. Together, at least. It's kind of dark at the top. Get the picture and just have some, like, almost vein looking lines on its wing too. Just slightly blend that. Highlight some points. It gets really white right here near the body. It's a little bit clearer. You can even almost see the wing underneath it. All the way around is this, like, white trim on its wing. So white wasn't a bad choice at all for this. blend that purple into the green a little bit. I don't know. Blending is my favorite. I don't know. It's pretty satisfying to me. The only thing about like chalk pastels is the cleanup. My fingers and the table, because I keep blowing it everywhere and I can't help it. All that chalk dust. You hear that wind? It's been a storm for a while. Actually had a tornado warning. I'm in Mass in the East Coast, so I mean there was a warning, but nothing actually went through, you know. It's, I feel like it's typically how it is around here. A lot of warning. Actually, you know, in some, usually Western Mass, I think, has more of a chance. I don't know. I'm really not sure. But we don't get hit often where I am. Light blend. Don't want to get rid of it, but don't want it to be so prominent. Get that white trim in there. Yeah, actually, I do see some purple on the outside, too. I'll get to that after. Some of that purple just on the edge. Clean finger. I don't know how, I'm sorry, but actually I just noticed, sorry about the shadow going through. You know, my lighting's not great. I just bought a light ring that goes around the phone, the camera on the phone. So like that'll be perfect for stuff like this. You won't hopefully not see any shadow. Yeah. All right, let's do these bottom wings. I'm just gonna fill it in real quick. It's mostly green. cooking finger. Blend it in. Get some transparency, right? I love the greens right now. I think next time I do this, I'm going to, like, clamp this thing down to the table, because I'm just pushing it everywhere. I love that green. Wow. That's so nice. Try to see some of the other colors. Oh. Let's get the purple, because there's more purple over here. Just on the edges, right? Very beautiful. I think the fact that I love blending so much, like, that's why I like doing pastels the most. I don't use them often, because I just, if I use like a pencil, I can get really detailed in what I'm doing. But if I pastel, I'm not there yet to do the super detail. So, but like the blending in it is just my favorite. Another thing about the Luna Moth, like just those natural colors, just go so well together. It's just such a beautiful creature, I would say. Let's see. Right in the middle. So much green now that it's tough. Maybe I won't blend that in as much. Got some purple in there too. I'm afraid of, but I want to blend it so bad. It's like an addiction, blending. Just tap it, we'll tap it in. It's not bad. Awesome. Some of that like reddish, corally in there. I'm gonna move it a little bit up. I don't know if my camera picks it up, but I love that. So the way you even stroke when you do things like this matters too. Or like it can add a lot more to it. Okay, let's see. see if it can make like a twisting effect, because that's what it does, it twists. So we'll bring that across. We'll bring this across. And then just like that.
Oh, can you not see the tail? My goodness, what am I doing?
Yeah. So you get these twists in there. But yeah, I think I went a little bit too hard on the bottom tails here. I don't think I'm able to race that well, so it won't be as defined as I want, but that's okay. Using dirty hands, playing it too much. Yeah, you know, I'm gonna see if we can get rid of some of that. I did get rid of some of it. Yeah. I like it. If we darken it up a little bit, it'll look more like it's twisting. We'll see. We'll try it out. Back with the eraser. Now, drawing is so much fun. Or I mean, you don't have to be good at it. Just like doing the art is really like zen. So it kind of brings you into your own space. You know? So, if you're a person that likes to draw or anything, any kind of art at all, like, don't neglect it. Because it's very relaxing and a lot of fun. And it doesn't have to be amazing. Just do what you like to do. Look at that. I just erased it, and I put my dirty finger in there. I just want to do a little more, some white touch-ups. The wings have these cool little... staggered white parts. Can you hear that thunder? I hope you can at least hear the rain. It's very nice. Just one last, like, I want to see if I can get some sharpness on these little tails. Let's see what we can do. Every time I worry super hard, I'm pretty sure I'm shaking the camera. I apologize if I am. What do I want to do now? I think all that's left is to work on the body, you know? Let's get some yellow. Ready? I'm gonna go wipe off my hands real quick, though, before I start using that color. Be right back. Alrighty, let's see how the camera's doing. Now, I'm pretty much finished with the tails. I don't think I'm gonna do much. So let's focus on the body here. It's a moth. It's funny, like, moths are just like fur balls, really.
their body. It's a lot of white, a lot of yellow right now. So let's... I think this side's a little green though. Because the wings overlap it a little bit. But there's definitely some translucence, and there's yellow in there too. So we get a layer of green. Let's see, I don't know how this yellow's gonna come out. Let's see. I mean, really, you don't see that much of the moth from the back, I don't think. But let's try to get... some dark outline here. Some heavy yellow. It's hard to see the yellow with all this green. There's some though. I actually like that the way it is. This little bump right here above the wing. His head pops out a little bit. Try to get some of that cottony fur look. And it has these cool little like antennae. We'll make this sharper, let's see. I don't want to try to tap it. It's very transparent, but it does kind of do one of these. Yeah. So I might just go over it with the eraser a little bit. I wonder if you can do like, has a little like, hairs in it. Kinda like that. That's cool. I like that. Probably what that one came out. And then I don't know what it is. Well, the
about the Luna Moth. I mean, it is called a Luna Moth, so it does remind me of the moon, right? That's like something like almost like spiritual or psychic about it. And I always like, whenever I picture it, I picture it like with this symbol above its head. Like the crescent moon. Which has some like esoteric meaning behind it. I mean, from what I've heard about that, it's like a, I don't know, psychic ability, really, I think. Psychic intuition, you know? That's what I've heard about it, at least. From what I've learned. I did not study symbols. But I did intuitively pick up on it when it comes to Luna Moth. So I like to like have it there. It makes sense to me. You know what though? I think that's gonna do it. Well guys, that was a lot of fun. I'm pretty tired right now. I'm gonna clean up and head to bed soon. But if you made it all the way through, thank you for watching. I had a great time doing this, and I had a great time sharing it with you guys. If you like to draw or anything, share your work with me. I would love to see it. I'd love to see all artwork. And as you can tell, I'm not professional here. I'm just having a lot of fun with the hobby. And art is art. Like, as long as you love it, who really cares, you know? So, I had a great time. Thank you for watching. Subscribe if you want to see more. I'll see you next time.